Okay, we'll be looking at considered authority. Another learning objective, we'll be looking at the definition of considered authority, then types of considered authority, as well as the function of each type of this considered authority. So this is what we're going to look at today. In the topic, we have an adjective and we have a noun. The adjective is constituted and the noun is authority. And I believe if at all you are not familiar with constituted, majority of you will be familiar with authority. When we say authority, let me go now. I will say this, the science students, I'm going to drill the government students. What is authority? Because that is one of the basic concepts of government. What is authority? It is on that I will move. What is authority? Government students, now let me call you. Start raising your hand now. Government students. By Jessica, I better turn on your video now. Okay, Joshua, turn on your video and answer the question. I told you my rules. Yes, Joshua, what is considered authority? And what is authority, I mean? Yes, I'm with you, Joshua. Joshua, are you with me? Okay, who else? Oluwaleke, yes?
This, the constituted authority can define.
What is authority? Calm down. I said, what is authority? It's
authority
a topic in government.
Authority can be defined as giving individuals legal individuals have legal power legitimately.
This is an incomplete explanation. If I should call the science students and some of them will tell you what authority is, and that would be as an insult to your sensibility. And if I call divine, and divine will tell you what authority is. I call my girlfriend will tell me, if I call Ojo, Ojo will quickly type now, send to me that authority is this. I'm sure. Okay. Ogwesho. Ogwesho, what is authority?
Authority is the power. Is the power giving.
Authority is the power.
To some people. Yes, sir.
No. Authority. If authority is power, what is power itself? Power is another basic concept of government. If authority is power, then what is power itself? Okay. That is.
Authority is the ability.
Eh?
Sir.
Yes, I'm listening to you.
Authority is the ability of people.
Thank you. Since you don't understand what I say, because the concept you are using, I'm not pleased with them. Let me listen to Grace. Grace, you have the floor. Grace, you raise your hand. Really, I'm coming. I can see your hand too.
Yes. Authority can be defined as the power or right to give orders.
You have combined two things. You see, authority is the power or right. The difference between authority and power. Okay. Saddam said the power or right to give order, make decision, and enforce obedience. There are some things that are combined there. The difference between power and authority. Now, okay, No, Ronin, another person will come to you. I will even lower your hand. Let me tell you what we said. Authority. Authority is the right to compel obedience. Government students. And why power is the ability to enforce obedience or compel obedience. One is the right, while the other one is ability. Power go with ability. Authority go with the right. And when we say right, it means that you are recognized to enforce the order. That is why it is an authority. I think that is understood now. I say authority is the right to enforce obedience. What that means is that there are certain rules and regulations, there are certain principles that are put in place, and you are recognized to have the capacity to ensure the obedience. For instance, now, I am here now. If I said, Rooney, don't talk. Will you talk? You will not talk. Why? Because you have seen me as a person that has the right to enforce the decorum in the class as your teacher. But when looking at ability, because some of you don't understand between the difference between power and authority. Ability involve and authority. Power involve your ability. Ability to enforce that somebody obey you. For instance, I am not your teacher. I'm not known to you. I just accost you on the way. And you see me, I'm very huge. Good. I said, hey, Licky, tell me carry this bag. And you look at me. You look at the distance between me and yourself. And you look at the chest, look at everything. If you don't want to carry it, you decide to like, if I refuse to carry it now, this man will finish me. If you carry it with one finger, I'm finished. Let me just carry it. Okay, the man has compelled you to do what you shouldn't have done because of the ability in him, what you have seen in him. Understand? And that is why that authority can be delegated, but power cannot be delegated to government students and the science in the head that may need you may try to like, because these are some questions can come across in objective. Why is that you can delegate authority, cannot delegate power? Power involve yourself, involving your capacity, your person to enforce it. While authority, there are laid down rules and regulations of which your office is trying to enforce. You don't need to be there. Just imagine during the school period, maybe your class captain comes to you that Mr. Emmanuel says you must submit your assignments between now and tomorrow. Okay, I'm not there, but the class captain is telling you. You know that this is the authority coming from Mr. Emmanuel. It's not the one. I'm not forcing you. The class captain is not forcing. Just that he's passing the information, and you know that this man has the right. He has the legal right to ensure that that note is submitted. For the fact that I wasn't there, you will do it. But if you see a giant sent me to you, and I'm not a giant, that I should do this, will you do it? And that giant does not have any right to control you. You will not do it because who is the person? You don't even know the person. So, but today, we are looking at authority in another perspective. We said constituted. When we say constituted, let's start from the word constitute. When we constitute, we have gathered or we have put together other people or some things. When we constitute, we put or gather or put people or some things together. We constitute. We can constitute a committee. We can constitute a member of a panel, a stand. But here, we are not looking at a committee. We are looking at constituted authority. That is, a group, individual, that are meant to enforce certain rules and regulations or to uphold certain protocols in the society. or at family level, in any gathering, in any association of a human being. Let me start from your home, your father, your mother, your elder brothers, your elder sisters. You know that they are part of considered authority at home. Yes, I have a question. If you have a contrary opinion and you say no, and if you believe in that, I want your yes, and I want you to tell me why you think that they are part of considered authority at home. Yes, response. I should start calling. Brian, why do you think your brother, your sister, your elder brother, your elder sister, your father, your mother are considered authority at home? Why? Unmute yourself and answer my question.
Because they are older than you and should respect, show respect.
Sir?
Because they are older than you should be able to show respect.
Okay, that is another angle. I take that from that angle. Okay. Temiduri. Why do you think your father, your mother, your elder brothers, your elder sisters are considered authority at home? Yes, I'm with you.
Yes, they are considered authority.
I'm with you. Speak. Okay, without taking much of my time, because I know Timidri may be trying to send me a message. Okay, they are considered authority because they are the ones saddled with the responsibility to manage the home. If your father has some rules to take at home, the same way with your mother. But in case the absence of your father or your mother, who will take the responsibility? It's either your elder sister or your elder brother. You must respect them. Failure to respect them and you are reported to your parents when they come back, you are in trouble. Okay? Because even as custom require, when I say custom, as our tradition requires, you must respect your elder ones and you must respect your parents, even biblically. If you want to be, if you want to stay long in this world, I want to be well with you. What do you do? The Christian here, what do you do? What does the Bible say? I think in book, or is it proverb or where? Yes. Yes. What does the Bible say about your father and your mother? If you want to, want it to be prosper for you in the world.
Mother.
You must what? Talk now, you are making sense.
Obey your father and mother.
Yes, in all things. In all things, you obey your father and mother because they are constituted the authority. Okay, that is at home. But I'm not looking at consular authority at home. I just have to come from that level. Since you know that you must obey your parents, you must obey your elder brothers and sisters. In the society, there are authorities that are put in place that you must obey. And these authorities are what we refer to as constituted authority. From that, let me take, in a summary based on what I've said now, I want somebody to now encapsulate what constituted authority means for me. Before I go to the next slide, let me hear from what I have said now. We are looking at constituted authority and larger society. Then how will you now conjugate the words and give me an acceptable definition as regards constituted authority? Yes, anybody? Yes, Oluwaleke.
Yes, sir. Constituted authority can be defined as authority that are conferred on individuals in the society.
Confined are constituted authority. You are getting it. But let me listen to Sheyi before I will make certain correction. Sheyi.
Constituted authority is the rights. The rights. That are entrenched in the constitution.
Entrusted. Okay. You are taking another direction now. You are in constitution. Yes. Continue.
Rights that are entrenched in the constitution.
Okay, I know that you have an idea of what you want to say. Possibly you don't know how to place the idea very well. Okay. When we say constitutional authority, it's not only in the constitution, it's not only in the perspective of constitution alone. It's not only in the perspective of the constitution alone. It could be as a result of norms, as you can see, that this may be defined as the lawful or constitutional power conferred or given to individuals. Given to individuals, group to manage a particular entity. Now, when I say lawful, you should understand, please, who is sending a message? Oh, Dominion, you are welcome. Dominion, when I ask question, you respond. When I'm talking, I will not read your message, but in case of next time. But for the first time, Dominion said, consider authority can be defined as the stated list of laws created to guide all the actions and rules in the society. Okay, Domino, you are talking about constitution, not constituted authority. Okay? While we're talking of constituted authority, we are looking at lawful or constitutional power conferred or given to individuals or group of people to manage a particular place or entity. Just as I said that time, that about your father, about your mother. Your father and your mother are conferred with certain privileges at home. Why? Because they give birth to you. The Bible says you must honor them, you must respect them. Therefore, they are embodiment of what authority that you must obey. And we are not looking at considered authority at that level. We are looking at it in the perspective of the society at large. Meaning that it could be a group of people. It could be an individual. It could be even an instrument. I will get to that under the tithes. It could be an instrument that has been recognized. Look at that, I said lawful. Lawful or constitutional power conferred on that person or that instrument, which you and I must what? Respect or obey. So when we have individual or group of people that have been given legal rights, either through the constitution or through the customs and norms of the society, to carry out specific decisions which are binding legally on the people. So those people now, all in the individual, are called constituted authority. And aside that, it could be an instrument, okay? If an instrument or a symbol that you must honor has been empowered for you to respect, that becomes a constituted authority. So some of you may be surprised that when I say, is it possible for you to honor a symbol or instrument? Yes. How many of you know that whenever you are reciting our national anthem, what do? Do you move? Am I communicating?
Yes, sir.
So some of you may be wondering that when we say, when I refer to like some instrument or symbol as considered authority, you may be surprised at how come. And I ask you that when we are reciting national anthem, are you permitted to move from one place to another?
No, sir.
No, you stand still. Why? Because authority has been conferred on the national anthem, on the on the national pledge, that whenever the national anthem is being recited and you are reciting the national pledge, you must stand still. Therefore, the national anthem become an instrument, become a symbol for a kind of conceded authority as a something that is not even human being this time around. We'll do more about that under the tithes. Our naira is our national symbol. Do you think you have the right to squeeze the naira on normal ground in the same country? If you squeeze the currency, you'll be arrested. If you are not aware, the currency is supposed to be guided and packed very well, treated like human being, treated with respect and regard. So all this becomes constituted entity for you to honor. Because power has been conferred on that do it this way, do it that way. So when I'm saying an individual now, you can see the governor, executive governor of Lagos State here. He is a constituted authority, as he has been conferred with power to manage the affairs of the state, having been elected as the executive governor of Lagos State. This is an example of an individual as a constituted authority. The president of the country, having been elected as the president of the country, is a constituted authority, and he must be respected. Yes? Omotosho, be careful. Okay? So just raise that issue under the question and answer, okay? So, I said the governor is a constituted authority. The member of the State House of Assembly, there are groups of individuals elected as constituted authority to make law on behalf of the people in the state. And the one is National Assembly, there are groups of individuals considered authority to make laws as entity to ensure that the smooth running of affairs of the people in the state. So the leadership could be on individual, it could be on the group of people, and it could be on an instrument or a symbol. That is what I'm trying to pass across here. I believe that is understood very well. If you don't understand that, let me see your hands up. Okay, I believe you've all understood that. And I said, as a matter of fact, if you have constitution, we don't have authority conferred on individual to implement the constitution, what will happen to the constitution? The constitution will be what? Useless. Therefore, in every association of human beings, there must be constituted authority. At the school, we have constituted authority, the principals, the vice principals, the HODs, the teacher, the subject teachers, the class teachers, and other authority concerned are example of constituted authority at the school level. In every association, we have constituted authority. At the government level, we are concerned, so just as I started in case of His Excellency Babajide Sanwo-Olu. And for your information, in every kingdom, we have constituted authority. We have Timba Jessica, your hands are started. We have the traditional rulers that serve as constituted authority. Please, I have not recognized you. You have, for instance, now in Ife, we have Oni as a constituted authority, as the one that follows and upholds the traditions of the people. Please, Simba Jessica, mute yourself. Okay, they follow the affairs of the people. We have the Alaafin of Oyo. We have the Akinolu of Lagos. We have all these individuals that are considered authority that uphold the customs and norms of the people. They are recognized by the traditions. And whatever they say becomes binding on the people that they are governing as the king. Please, if it's not time, Jessica, where are you? You were raising your hand. What is it? All right. When she's ready to speak, we'll know. Then there are about six types of consular authority that I'm going to highlight, but in our next class, we're going to take them one after the other. Now take them one after the other. I'll also expatiate on their functions or on their importance, because these are fundamental questions you are going to come across. This number one here, we have traditional considered authority. I've mentioned now. Okay, let me listen. You can give me that. Bruni, tell me, give me one example of traditional considered authority. One example. Example of considered authority. Example of traditional considered authority, I mean. Yes, is that
Obas?
The Obas. The Obas. It's example, okay? The Obas. The Emias. Oh, okay. Divine says parents. Emias. Okay. Allah for you. Thank you, Temidiri. Olualeke, Emias, thank you very much. Okay? Okay. So the examples. So please, I'm going to deal with everything critically. You should know. Okay? We say religious considered authority. Can you give me an example? Example of religious considered authority.
So
mute yourself, Rooney. I'm not taking it from you again. You have spoken. Oriwu Precious. I will deal with you. Where is the Queen Ogbon? Okay, pastors. Babatunde Femi, say pastors. Yes, Dominion, say pastors. Okay, all of you, I say pastors. Bishop, yes, thank you. Imam, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Temidiri said bishop. Oluwaleke said imam. Babatunde Femi also said imam. Thank you very much. These are examples of religious. Don't forget that the Ifa priest too is also a constituted authority on religious grounds. Sheyi, you are surprised. We have in Nigeria now, we have three types of religion recognized. We have the traditional religion, that is ATR, African traditional religion. And we have, okay, sure I receive your message. Pope is an example of a religious constituted authority. So please take note of that ATR is another religion Nigeria recognized. Okay, we have government constituted authority. Government constituted authority. Grace, I receive your message. Chief priest is an example of a religious constituted authority. Thank you very much. Example of government constituted authority. Yes, yes. You push you speak. You're always good in sending messages. Okay, senators. Yeah. Oluwaleke said senator. President, according to Babafemi, yes, you are correct. Rooney said governor. President, thank you very much. You are correct. The example of a constituted example of government constituted authority. Thank you very much. It seems that you know what it takes. You have legal or rational constituted authority. I think the government students should be able to do something better in this area based on the concept of types of authority that they were taught in SS1 first step under the basic concept of government. Legal or rational constituted authority. Yes, who is giving an example? Yes, yes, I have a few minutes to go. Legal or rational authority or considered authority, example. Nobody. Who is sending message? Judges, Oluwaleke, thank you very much. The judges, the magistrate, the cadis. Okay, you don't know who is cadis, go and ask who Palo the affairs of the Sharia court. Sharia court, who Palo the affairs? Who is the judge, or the name called the judge in the Sharia court? Okay, so the judges, the magistrates, the cadis, these are examples of legal or rational considered authority. We'll deal with them in detail when we come to the level, okay? Then we have organizational or administrative considered authority. Without wasting my time, this authority confined on individuals like directors in a company, like a manager, among other, like permanent secretary, among other in any establishment. They are considered authority. If you don't respect your manager, if you don't respect your director, you are in soup. you know what it means, you're on your way. Query will follow query. And now when the query accumulates, you know what it means, you're on your way out of the establishment. Okay? So this essay you sent to me, I got on. Thank you very much. I appreciate what you sent. Thank you very much. I'm not going to do it. I'm only asking for the question. I appreciate. God bless you. So this also have instrumental authority. Instrumental consulted authority. The example of what I told you that time, our currency, national anthem, national pledge, they are instrumental consulted authority. You must respect them. Failure to respect them, you are in soup. So we'll deal with all this in detail when time comes. Okay? We'll deal with all of them in detail when time comes. Thank you very much. That's where I'm going to stop for today. And it is time for me to take your question if there's any. God bless you. Question time.
So you said our parents and siblings are constituted authority. Which type do they fall under?
You said, can you please recap?
You said our parents and our siblings.
Yes, I can hear you. Parents are considered authority. Which area do they fall in, right?
Which type of considered authority?
Automatically, your parents fall under the tradition. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Because are you following the rules and guidelines of your parents based on the concern of the country or based on what the tradition says?
What the tradition says.
So, thank you very much. So, they fall on that. I believe I've answered your question very well, right?
Yes, sir.
All right. Oluwaleke, your question.
Okay, sir. Sir, what's the difference between legal or rational constituted authority and government constituted authority?
Thank you very much. The legal and rational constituted authority, they are meant to settle disputes. I think that should have been solved in your government under rational. I don't know if you were taught types of authority. You should have been taught. We have legal or rational authority. Then we have political authority. Under the legal or rational authority, powers are conferred on the individual to ensure that they preside over constitutional matters, resolving conflicts with that allow into snowball into crisis. Okay? But in the government constituted authority, those individuals in that arena, they are appointed politically. The governors, the ministers, the president, but the rationale, they are not politically appointed. They are appointed based on their professions to pilot the affairs of the state in time of administering justice. Hello, Leke.
Yes, sir.
Have I answered your question?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. Is there another question? Any other question? Okay. In absence of further question, I'm convinced that you are able to understand the fact that today we have thought about considered authority and you know what considered authority is now and you already acquainted with the types. Then I will want you to take this home. In our next class, I will ask you, when we say respect for considered authority, what does it mean? This is a take home for you to go and ruminate on. Thank you very much. I will send the link for my assignment very soon. Make sure you do my assignment as usual and submit before 6 p.m. on Sunday. God bless all of you.